Hi everyone. It's much more fun with a band than in a typical Zoom meeting where you know sit there all alone. I would wish I would have that more often. Thank you. How is everyone doing? It's a long day. We are getting towards the end of the official program, and then there's going to be the unofficial evening program. And to bridge that gap, at some point in time during my talk, I will be talking about beer. So after the sausage that we just talked about, or the sausage making, it's going to be beer in this talk. As you just heard, I have the pleasure to lead the challenge program at Sprint. And Sprint is the federal agency for disruptive innovation, or in German, the Bundesagentur für Sprunginnovation. That might sound a bit contradictory at best. So we want to let you, the innovators, be the judge in the coming weeks, months, years on whether we can solve that contradiction. Our mission is to identify and fund enable breakthrough technologies. And I think that's also something that is particularly crucial to arrive at a circular economy. It's absolutely clear that technology will not be sufficient to arrive at a circular economy. But I think at the same time, it's necessary, especially when it comes to reshaping the backbone of our industry. And especially in Germany, where kind of the big part of our backbone of our industry is manufacturing, that's something where new technologies are desperately needed. And that's something that we want to address with that very challenge, with the challenge on circular biomanufacturing. And just so that you don't have me talking here all the time, I'm going to have a very short video now coming that guides you a bit through the question of what that actually is and why we should want to achieve that.
Our economy is built on a single-use industrial production system, but our natural resources are limited. Biology already manages to create self-reproducing and sustainable production systems, creating a circular economy that turns waste streams into the foundation for industrial production would create a paradigm shift, enabling sustainable and resilient manufacturing. To achieve this goal, novel biomanufacturing technologies need to be developed. Existing biomanufacturing technologies exhibit high costs and low yields, making them unsuitable for mass production. We need to rethink value creation holistically, in the sense of a bio-based economy. Let's establish new bio-based production approaches based on a circular, local, and sustainable manufacturing process. That's why we need you. Innovators, scientists, entrepreneurs, your challenge. Create a circular biomanufacturing enterprise. Show us disruptive new ideas on how the bio-based industry can competitively produce large quantities of raw materials and products at low cost. Unleash your genius and dare to dream.
So our vision for circular manufacturing is that we can use carbonaceous waste streams, feed these to microbes, which then produce new materials that are directly used in advanced manufacturing processes. And that is pretty similar to brewing beer. Because if you think about it, beer brewing is a process where you take the mash, add yeast, and that yeast eats up the sugars in the mash and produces alcohol and CO2. The difference being, we want to use waste streams and not high quality, highly refined sugars, but really waste streams like agricultural waste, gray water, black water, anything, and feed that to the microbes that then produce new materials, polymers, or whatnot, to directly add these into manufacturing processes. What the previous panel talked about is that we need to get out of the fringes with approaches to the circular economy. We need to get out of the niche. We need to get mainstream, and we need to find the solution that makes circular manufacturing the default for manufacturing in this century. And we think that biotechnology can be a key enabler for that, but it's a very hard task. There are parts of the puzzle that exist, but we are far away from actually proving that we can do that at scale at low cost for bulk materials, and not only for a limited quantity of, say, fragrances or aromas as is currently done. So what we do is we have that challenge, that's our goal. We fund up to 8 companies with about 40 million euros to achieve that goal. So there is money. We hope there will be solutions, but typically there are. But I think money itself typically wasn't the big problem, the bottleneck, when it comes to enabling breakthrough innovations. Typically, it's not the money itself, at least. Typically, it's the question of how that money is spent by public institutions. And think about that. What we want to have are innovators that develop technologies that are the world's envy. We want them to build companies that tear down walls, create new markets, and be market leaders. And then we drown them in lengthy application processes, bureaucracy, and a lot of bullshit paperwork. And that's just crazy. Because, you know, that's the brightest minds of our generation that are willing and capable to solve the world's problems, and we keep them busy filling out forms. And that has to change, because when we look at breakthrough technologies, not always, but often, these are deep technological developments that need to be done, that are far too risky for VCs, for example, to fund. And so for us, there is a clear role for public engagement, for public institutions to fund that. But so far, there's a mismatch that prevents us from effectively doing that. And that's exactly what we try to do at Sprint with Sprint Challenges. So for example, if you would apply to that challenge, deadline is 17 September. So there's some time if you haven't seen that and are quick to bring in the team and develop the concept, you can still apply. What you will then see is that within 2 to 3 weeks, you get a first reply, a first decision on your application. There's going to be a final decision within 6 weeks in total. And teams typically have the signed contract from our side on the desk the next morning. And that gives them directly access to the funding. The only thing they need to do is sign the contract themselves, send us an invoice, get the money, and that way we fund companies, academic institutions, whatever institution, within days. And that's exactly what we want to see. We want to be low in bureaucracy. We want to enable those who are really capable of changing the world. And we want them to be able to contribute to the ecosystem by developing the first demonstrators of hopefully groundbreaking new technologies, and with that to contribute to the ecosystem that you're all part of. That's also where we want to engage in as well, to bring together that ecosystem, shape the ecosystem, enable you. And that's also why I'm really thankful that we have that DLD circular today, to bring in all you great people, make the connections, and do the work, which is a lot of work and is a long way out to actually achieve the goal that we all share. So I'm very interested in talking to all of you who have ideas about circular manufacturing or the circular economy in general. So get in touch, and let's change the world. Thank you.